He's real. And I say, Lord, I was looking at the TV. I think I was talking to Sister Holly. And Doris had it on that, whatever that show is, the Wild Wild Hoax, and the folks doing the dances. I was going, so, what is it?
106
Yeah, there you go. They was doing all this stuff, and I was just sitting there looking, and my spirit just got sick. I felt like throwing up. And I'm telling you why I felt like throwing up. I said, no, because I looked out at those young people, and I said, God, I said, the enemy here, my young people, mine is so corrupt. So corrupt. He got them thinking they're doing right, and they're doing wrong all the time. He got them thinking right is right, right is wrong, and wrong is right. And you can't tell them nothing. And that's why the Bible says we should be walking epistles of Christ and let every man mark that perfect man. That's why we have to live holy and upright before these young people. Because these young people going to do what they see us do. Because they're not the church of tomorrow. They're the church of today. And whatever they see you doing, come that's what they're going to do.
Come on.
And a lot of times, like the Bible said, you reap what you sow. A lot of us parents have sowed bad seeds back in the day. Now it has sprung up in our kids.
Come on,
and we're trying to figure out what's wrong with it.
Let's go.
You sold it 10 years ago.
Man.
Man. And it's just now showing up. Any mother that has a daughter that sleep with multiple men, and your daughter saw that, that's a generational curse.
Yeah.
And if it's not broken up in that child's life, she gonna grow up doing the same thing mama did.
Come on, girl, man.
Sleeping with multiple men. And you gonna try to tell that ain't right. You know you need to get yourself together. God ain't pleased with that. What he wasn't pleased with you was doing the evil.
Yeah.
What's good for the goose is good for the gallery. You ain't just been so long. You done got saved now. You done got your life together now. You done forgot what you did.
Yeah.
to be willing to let go of some in order to gain some.
Yeah, yeah.
And God can work through us like He wants to except we let go of ourselves.
Yeah, right.
It's been quiet in here all morning.
You break it.
Everybody been seeing it? Everybody been seeing it? You're going to be willing to go all the way.
Yeah.
Come out of yourself. Give your whole self to God.
Amen.
Give your whole self to God.
Yeah.
Let all that stuff go.
Yeah.
And we have the destiny to get angry and upset with God because we're in the same situation. The song say, give me you everything else, then wait, you don't want God, baby. You don't want God. Because if you did, you'll do like the other songwriter say, give myself away.
Right.
Right. You'll give you up.
Yeah.
You'll give you up.
Amen.
So that God can use you.
Yeah.
Don't get mad because you're using somebody else. They making themselves available.
Yeah.
A man can't marry a woman except she's available.
Yeah.
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 Come on, man. You're right about like that. You're right.
You
know. Vice versa. A woman can't marry a man.
Yeah.
Unless he's available.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can't marry that man that he already tied to somebody.
Yeah.
That's why they call them a mistress.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
A mistress is somebody you don't know about on the side.
Yeah.
And I refuse to be a mistress.
Yeah.
Of God.
Yeah.
I'm married to the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
I'm not a mistress.
Yeah.
Come on, Pastor, that's good.
Some of us are mistress. You ain't married to God. You ain't married to God. You're a mistress. You're not married to God. You're married to Him with lip service. But your heart ain't yoked up
with
Him.
Okay.
Your heart ain't yoked up with Him. We've got to be married to God and practice the things of God. A marriage ain't going to work. We're one doing what they're going to do, we're one doing what they're going to do.
Right, yeah. Right. Yeah, yeah.
It ain't gonna work. Two people are married, they are always supposed to walk in agreement.
Always. Yeah.
Even when they disagree,
yeah,
they're supposed to come to an agreement.
Yeah.
And we are supposed to be in agreement with the Holy Ghost. And if you are not in agreement with the things of God, then you're none of Him. Because you can't do the things you want to do and say, well, God, this is what I need to do right here. And I do this little part for you.
Yeah.
Now He wants all of you.
Yeah.
There you go, all or nothing. My former pastor wife used to say all the time, she said, baby, she would be related to, you know, a married couple. You know how women sometimes complain, you know, about their husband, they come home and this, that, and the other. She used to say all the time, she said, baby, she said, a piece of broom is better than a broom at all. That's for the man, but with God, he need that whole stick.
Yeah. Yeah. Come on, man. Yeah. Oh.
piece of broom ain't gonna work with God. Some of y'all just dating God. Y'all ain't gonna like me, but I told you earlier, baby, Jesus is my friend.
Come on, Pastor.
I told you earlier, Jesus is my friend.
Sure did.
See, some of y'all just dating God. You know, y'all just go out with him every now and then. I'm breaking off on you. Y'all just go out with him every now and then. In other words, you serve him when you feel like it.
Yeah.
Every now and then. Well, I feel like you're going to church today, so I'm going to go to church. Next time you say, y'all don't feel like going to church today, so you don't feel like dating today. Yeah. Don't feel like dating today. Wow. So some of y'all just dating God. Some of y'all claiming him, but he ain't claiming you. Oh, I know it's heavy. I know it's heavy. Yeah, some of y'all claiming him, but he ain't claiming you. You know how it is, these chicks, they be talking about, oh yeah, me and Jobo is together. Child, Jobo ain't really claiming you. Jobo don't know me but you. Start telling everybody that we will him, but he don't know who's saying that. Same way it is with God.
My.
Claiming him, but he ain't claiming us. Going around telling folks you still married. You've been divorced. My son say long time ago. You still what they call the thing? You still wearing that wing? Got your swag? Yeah. And you been divorced? Saying we still saved, sanctified, and filled with the Holy Ghost, and God divorced you 2 years ago. You still saying you still married. You ain't married no more. And you gonna find out too when you get to that courthouse.
Come on.
Ain't talking about downtown, I'm talking about uptown.
Yeah, okay.
I'm on your road. are you willing to let go?
Tell you blessings.